But at the same time, in the ghetto, I was involved with the illegal youth organization, the social democratic youth organization called Future, Zukunft. And we used to come together, illegal groups, having all kind of lectures, listening to even to music sometimes, having a seminar. But these were small groups reading illegal literature. And this was, in a way, a little bit of an involvement, which my mother, although she was not too much anxious for us to do this kind of work, knowing that if it will be found out, then dead. It was no school at that time in the ghetto. And we, the young people, started to be involved in teaching the children in the so-called, we called this the children corners, where children who were not able to go to school, the schools were closed, we used to take them together to teach them songs, to teach them how to write, and in a way, giving them a little bit of life. And in the houses there, there were created house committees to help the starvation which started in the ghetto. In the ghetto, in the Warsaw Ghetto itself, over 2,000 house committees were created by the Jews themselves, the so-called self-help. An illegal Jewish cultural organization was created, and we, the young people, started to have seminars, I recall, that and later assigned to places to go after the curfew and to have lectures for the people of the houses, which were closed up. So I, a 16, 17-year-old, went to such lecture, and I recall it was on Pavia 30, and I was talking about parrots, about Bonche Schweig at this particular lecture, and two young people, children, were outside, the windows were covered, in case German will come and knock, to have time that we will be able to disperse. And I slept over at that time in one of the apartments of the people. It's very difficult for me to say how the lecture, what they talked, but I still remember the atmosphere, the uplift, that in the ghetto was so much starvation and the typhoid epidemic which started, and hunger and misery. We were talking about literature. And a young girl was talking to older people, and they were listening. And somehow it was the thought, the hope that this will pass. It is a time that will not remain forever. And this kind of hope was constantly in the life of the ghetto.